Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner. In this episode, we're going to talk about pointer arithmetic. So yes, I am available still for code reviews and on-site training. And I also have some upcoming workshops at NDC Tech Town and plausibly at CBPCon coming up. So be sure to check those out in the video description below. Now, let's say you are following all of my best practices and you end up on code like this. This function signature that you have is not your fault. This is some sort of C callback or something. Just for the record, do not ever create code like this on your own, but you are in some sort of sticky situation and you have this and you're saying, I am trying to do the right thing, compiler. I am passing this into a vector. How am I supposed to get around this warning? Now, this is your very first potential option. You're just going to use standard next. Now, we do have this narrowing conversion changes signedness because this is an unsigned size T, and standard next actually expects a signed size T so that it can actually go forward or backward. And we can use pointer diff t, which is an appropriate type in this situation, and do this cast instead. And now we are not going to have that particular warning anymore. So that's your very first option. This still is kind of pointer arithmetic, but it's being hidden from you and being done by the compiler. Now, your next option is to simply take advantage of span, which I really like. Of course, this would be better handled by our standard print, but we don't currently have standard print in our compiler, so that's unfortunate. But we're just creating a span that starts at argv and continues for the count of argc objects. That is spectacular. And span has the double advantage that it can work with our ranges and views. And now it is possible that you find this entirely too wordy, and you should keep in mind that you can pretty easily also create a subrange where I am just saying, please give me the same span, but skip the first two elements. So those are our two main options. The first one is to use standard next. This is a little bit wordy, but this works all the way back to C++ 11, 98, possibly even. I would have to double check that. And option two is a C++ 20 feature. And the rest of these ranges are C++ 20 features as well. So you could also have used string view here, which then would enable this for C++ 17. Well, I hope this gave you some ideas for how you might actually end up with better code instead of simply disabling a warning that you feel like there's no way around. And thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly, and be sure to subscribe.